Capital Games brings the biggest scam to Galaxy of Heroes?
I'm infuriated.
Capital Games takes away our favorite feature?
Mmm.
Insert mandatory General Grievous blurb?
Mmm.
Right after this message.
Mmm.
You must be advised. You are told.
I'm really upset about this box.
We are upset about this box. Capital Games, explain. We need a petition. Everyone, go to Reddit. Upvote this comment right here. We gotta bring the whole crate
back. Back.
I want the box back as well, people. This right here is why we make YouTube videos. We have to stand behind what we believe in. Yeah. The biggest
It's infuriating.
I'm about to uninstall the game right now. Now I need the money. You know what else is grinding my gears?
No Grievous portrait?
Oh, no, that's another thing. Right here, Capital Games scams the player base.
What a scam.
They moved the Bronzium packs to the front, ladies and gentlemen. And in return, people spent thousands of crystals because they accidentally bought a chromium pack all the way back here. How do you feel about that?
Wow, 350 crystals gone. You know, but that's actually a pretty big deal.
That is actually a huge deal.
Remember when it was like a whole minute?
Dude.
It was like, oh my God, it was like 35 things long.
Yeah. I mean, we're just joking, obviously. This is actually, it's funny. This is actually,
I actually think it's pretty good.
This is actually pretty significant for people. I posted a picture on Twitter about this and it became my most liked Twitter post or something. It got gold on Reddit because people are really excited about the fact that this was moved to the front. It is a quality of life feature. I felt like I was less likely to get the pack if it was hiding all the way in the back.
It always seemed kind of petty that they put it on the back.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
They make you scroll through all the stuff. Look at that right there. Beautiful. So that was really nice. We're just joking. Not a scam. Right, but it's not a scam. It's funny, though. They issued out crystals for people who accidentally did buy a pack. And as a result of going with a 2 to 3 year old habit of scrolling down everything, we want to talk about C-3PO because we haven't talked about this guy just yet.
Who's C-3PO?
I don't know. I heard he's pretty significant.
Is he coming to the game?
I heard he's everyone's favorite character right here. Easiest legendary of all time. You got lucky.
I got really lucky.
You got lucky.
Yeah,
man.
I didn't know how lucky I was until I edited and rewatched the footage and read the comments.
I read the comments and you heard me screaming.
And then I saw you not do it well, and then I've seen everybody else really struggling. I think I had like 6 middle revives. What are those 35%? I mean, I don't know what the odds are on that, but it was a 1 in 100.
Yeah,
run at
least. You made it sound so easy. And I'm sitting there for 3 hours.
I didn't even get to do the proper strategy of like going after like Chewbacca first. I mean, because the way I was playing, the way that the RNG was going, it didn't matter how I played it. I was just because I figured I was gonna take me hours. I was just gonna figure it out.
Right.
Just second attempt.
Made me jealous. How has he affected the game? So he's been out for pretty much exactly a week right now.
Right.
What is your week summary of C-3PO?
Okay, well, before he came to the game, I knew he was going to be a Theory Crafters character. I knew he was going to be good in the raid. I actually thought he was going to be more important in the arena.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to put that out there. Mm-hmm. And he's turning out not to be as important.
Mm-hmm.
But I also feel that he was going to be something important later, like BB-8 was.
Right,
So maybe it's something to do with Commander Luke or... maybe how we get Commander Luke, but the way his kit is drafted, there's so much potential.
Oh, and endless potential.
And so we're already seeing problems with it breaking the raid, phase three of the raid, which I think is where I think you're going with this conversation.
Basically, so yeah, we're going to talk about Arena in a second, but the first thing we want to mention is he did break the raids, especially the Sith raid. In phase 3, we're going to pull it up here right now, he basically allows a Finn team to get into an endless loop for the phase 3 of the Sith raid. So the developers have come out, they basically said, this is going to get patched. They're right now going on their 2-week break starting today, I think, or something like that. So when they come back, so they said they're either going to fix the raid Treya or fix Finn's Zeta. So I'm hoping that, they fix the raid Treya and fix how her tenacity works, because Finn's Zeta is a delicate Zeta to fix.
Yeah, all they have to really do is that when she's toppled, make some sort of stacking tenacity, maybe after the 20th hit or something. It doesn't have... I mean, I think the team, if they do it that way, it won't destroy this team.
Yeah.
And then when they build future raid bosses, they just have to have some sort of stacking tenacity mechanic to prevent this from happening.
Right. Yeah, and so aside from this raid, and I'm not sure how he's going to work after the whole patch goes live. I'm pretty sure he'll have some sort of purpose in the Sith raid. This will still be a decent team, just not an endless loop.
Right.
But the AAT raid, you were with me that day.
Yeah.
I'm probably going to make a video about this soon, but I went through the AAT raid of Jedi Training Raid, Resistance Trooper, and a bunch of droids, not optimized for the raid.
Yeah, because this has to be optimized.
This is
all
super optimized.
All potency.
Oh,
all potency.
All the way optimized for this type of thing.
And I think it works better with Leia than Ezra.
Ezra Bridger for more hits. Yeah, so we did it in my AAT raid, and basically after phase two, you can auto the whole entire thing with very minimum watching. That's the best we've gotten yet. Phase one, you still have to pay attention and make sure the strategy
phase
is right.
Phase one's a hassle no matter
what. Phase one's a hassle no matter what, but this is the closest we're getting to a full solo auto of the whole entire raid. So that's pretty big. I've never gotten 44 million damage in the raid before, so that was pretty big. Video coming about that soon.
Yeah,
so.
And would you get 10th?
It's funny. My whole entire guild basically managed to get in the top. It was like everyone had 40 plus million damage. It was kind of
48
funny.
And 44, right? He really didn't sweep the arena kind of the way. There's a couple teams here. There's a rebel team, of course. There's a rebel team with Thrawn.
The CLS team made the top 10, it looks like, so far. But, I mean, top 10, we're talking about 3%.
I imagine that's a fun team to play with. You know, there's no tanks. And then, you know, as long as you're getting all that resistance to the Pwnsion Rebels, then you're getting all that bonus turn meter, 5%.
You need the Zeta on Commander Luke's lead to make it work.
And so, you know, I imagine that they're targeting Jolie, who has ridiculous tenacity, or at least you should be modding him for tenacity.
Yeah.
And then plus the bonus tenacity.
Every time he's resisting, it's granting turn meter. Yeah.
Yeah, so it's an interesting team. I don't think it holds up well in defense.
Yeah, and then the Jedi training great team though. I showed, it's just started popping up. It's a... One thing we have to understand, C-3PO is a pretty difficult character to gear, and the trick with like Jedi Training Raid, which I love the team, I'm able to beat Revan with no problem, I'm able to beat everything else with no problem. It just really relies on BB-8 getting guard from Chewbacca, because BB-8 can't be outran by Revan.
Right.
All the bonus Terminator, BB-8 being a super speedy character, you're able to quickly keep calling Chewbacca to assist over and over again. So I really like that team. Makes Revan teams manageable. Even if Jolie revives the other team, I can just, it's like no biggie. Couple hits from Chewie and they're done.
Chewie's what makes that team
it's
really
the Chewie
work.
That
it's
makes,
a Chewie. And
I try to CLS and GK, it's like,
Well, and I think that's what's happening is like Chewie was maybe a Chewie and C-3PO might be a part of a bigger picture.
Exactly, yes.
Specifically, of course, you know, all leading up to Jedi Luke, but we don't know when that's going to happen. That's probably summer earliest. I mean, if I were to guess, no earlier than summertime.
Well, we all had our first Grand Arena.
A lot of fun.
This past week. I got to say this. I normally don't stream myself playing my normal account. It's like there's really nothing interesting. This is the first time I was excited to stream every single Grand Arena event that came around. So I'm a huge advocate for this event, and it's cool seeing that they did implement the whole 3v3 thing, which we're going to experience for the first time, so which could be a complete mess for all we know. We don't know yet. It's a lot of stuff in there. But what's how do you think about Grand Arena?
Okay, well, my initial thought is, like, holy moly, this is going to use, like, I'm over 4 million GP, and you're just under 4 million. So you got to put up 10 defensive squads. So just let's use you for the easy math. 10 times 3 is 30 times 2. 2.2, you know what I mean? Because you're going to need more teams to clean up. You know, you're going to set 10, you know, that's 60 minimum, 60, 70 characters. That's half of your roster.
Yeah, it's a lot of stuff. I mean, I'm showing it right now. This is why, you know, no one knew back then not to inflate your roster, but inflating your roster now puts you at a huge disadvantage. And so this is pretty much the defensive squads needed for the 3v3 Grand Arena, which is coming 10 for me on defense. And you're going to need at least 10 minimum on offense. Yeah, and then you're probably going to need some cleanup crew.
You're
going
to need 60, 70 G12 characters at some point. It's going to be crazy.
Yeah.
And mods to go with them.
Yeah. I mean.
So, I mean, it definitely is in-game content. It's pushing you to have a deeper roster. I think in the past you could focus on just your arena. And that's fine. But now, especially leadership, right? I mean, how many leaders are you going to need?
Oh, yeah.
You know, 10 times 2, 20 leaders,
I
right?
mean,
so you got to, it's like, wow, I never was going to Zeta, you know, this character. Well, now I might, you know, it's just like a lot of things.
Yeah.
I mean, there's so many different ways. This is actually, it's brilliant.
It's
really
very
is.
Nice.
I think it, a lot of people are commenting that it's their favorite game mode.
It's time to, I think it's, I haven't sat down for a long time in this game and actually sit there and make a strategy and be like, oh, this guy might do this. I'm going to do this in response. You know, you're looking at their roster. You're doing all this researching in advance versus Arena. Now it's like, if you have Revan, you're good to go. If you have C-3PO, you're good to go. Now Grand Arena mixes things up so much because you have to dig deep in this roster.
Well, and each,
I'm using Jawas. I'm using Jawas. I mean, like, heck.
Well, and unfortunately, there's not going to be any generic advice on this.
It's
your roster specifically, and then looking at their roster specifically. So it's going to play out differently every time.
Yeah.
And then, you know, and then you, once, you know, people are figure like that they're doing full wipes, then it's like, oh, wow, I got to, like, if I lose one character, I lose the whole match.
Right, yeah.
You know what I mean? So it's getting interesting.
It's getting very interesting, and I know we're going to talk about some very, we're going to point you towards some resources for what you can use for Grand Arena 3v3. The thing was 3v3, everyone's has a guide. I even made a video a while ago saying, oh, here's just some ideas, but that's all there. They're just ideas.
I'm gonna have to make a top 70
a top 70 characters.
Top 70 characters for the month of December. You know what I mean? Just so you can get in your Grand Arena teams right there.
I mean, we gotta, I mean, there's a lot of good graphics. I'll link some of these down below if you want to check them out, but these are all ideas. Nothing is gospel just yet. 3v3, it's already bad enough. Not bad enough, but it's already crazy how the 5v5 Grand Arena is mixing things up in terms of what you should be using. And now 3v3, now you got to deal with the element of we never had this where you're cutting characters out and you got to focus on stronger synergy between three characters and then get worry about putting them on offense, putting them on defense, what's better. So, I mean, there's some really good graphics showing some ideas like this team right here before Ness was nerfed against Revan. This was able to beat Revan teams.
Yeah, that team can wipe out a lot of teams.
Now, yeah, I mean,
there's not a lot of teams that can beat that. Probably.
No.
Because that once Master's Training is on Ness,
you can have a low gear Kira. She's not even that important.
And then Kira is gonna, you could do.
You just need the leadership from her.
You can
that's
get
it.
A 3-star on both of those guys. Well, they can't do 3-star on Hermit Yoda, but you know, 3-star Kira, 5-star. Hermit Yoda and a maxed out Nest, and that team is scary.
Yeah, that's a scary team right there. So right there is going to be crazy. I mean, there's some obvious ones like CLS and Han and Chewie. Yeah. That's really obvious.
I like Jin with Chirrut and Baze. I mean, this new gun, that's an evil team right there.
Yeah, because Newt hides the Acolyte under stealth 24/7, so you're always forced to go after zombies. So you need an AoE team to go up against that.
And then probably the Sith trio, the Triumvirate, is probably the strongest. It's better than Revan.
But even with that.
We don't know. It doesn't look like Revan's going to be the best team in this mode.
Yeah, Revan's a 5v5 team. Yeah, with Revan with only two others, how does that work? And even with the Triumvirate, the Triumvirate would seem like a good team, but do you want to save Nihilus for something else maybe? Or, The door is busted. They kicked the door down. Here's another nice graphic again. I'll share these down below. So just ideas to get the thoughts jogging because right now there's endless possibilities of theory crafting and it's going to be a long time until we have like a definite list like, these are going to be good. Moving on to what you guys probably heard a lot by now. Data mines. Minecraft data mines. You know, you're digging. You
Roblox
find that gem.
Roblox is better.
Roblox is better according to Mobile Gamer, right?
Yeah. I knew everything about it.
So, data mine. So there was a big patch. As we said, the developers are going on their break soon.
Right.
And probably what's going on is that since they're going to be gone for 2 weeks, they kind of already snuck in the next update in this
early.
December 19th patch early.
Because they're gone.
It's because they're gone. So when January hits, they don't have to have someone go to the studio to program it.
The data mines are usually only available like 2 days out, and it's
usually.
Not that important. And usually we get a post or something, so there's nothing in the
this
data
mine. This is 2 weeks early,
though. Yeah, so this is 2 weeks early. So we've got two important things here. Basically, Slave 1 is the logon for the month of January. We'll talk about that. And the second one is
all the territory
war bonuses. And there's a couple things that we picked up in there that kind of allude to future characters potentially.
Right. So we'll talk about the Slave 1 part first in case you guys didn't see the other videos that we talked about. But basically, we're thinking this is indicating that the original Trilogy Falcon is coming to the game. That's the speculation.
It confirms the leak even more.
It confirms the leak even more, basically.
Yeah.
That leak was... That screenshot came out pretty legit. I mean, we're not going to harp on too much about it. Just very specific stuff was laid out in that whole screenshot. So even though it didn't happen in December, I think they rearranged the schedule and they're just kicking it over the next quarter. So very possible... Hopefully Grievous is going to be next quarter.
Over there.
It's the gaming environment. Just a little we know about what happens behind the
everything
scenes.
Everything is last minute.
Last minute. So it could very well be possible that the Slave 1 is indicating bounty hunters. Maybe some people said maybe bounty hunters and empire needed for the Millennium Falcon. Which
I mean, I don't know how many original Trilogy Falcon speculation videos we've made, but this this just kind of compounds that.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, come on. And so, you know, and look at what's hard and farmable right now, which is going to be scoundrels and bounty hunters.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, if they're going to make it a panic farm situation, which is classic Capital Games, you know, it's right now is the time, you know, run, don't walk, start farming these bounty hunters, start farming these scoundrels.
The Millennium Falcon is kind of like the Jedi Luke of ships, sort of very iconic, most popular ship out there.
You know, the people that are into ships, though, are the real whales.
Oh, yeah. Remember
more so than, I mean, there's some people that spend sometimes and they tend not to be like as big on ships. The people that are really into ships are spenders.
When the Millennium, the Resistance Millennium Falcon came out in the pack, that was a couple thousand dollars to get.
Yeah, that was a
and that was a horrible ship.
That was a novelty.
It was a novelty.
It's like Grievous was. Grievous and the original Millennium Falcon, not original, but episode 7.
Episode 7,
yeah. It was a novelty when it first came out.
Moving on to this, which is more than just data mined information of what is to come for Territory War. So it's Territory War bonuses. I was a fan of those in November. Yep. You liked them too. You thought maybe Mace Windu was a little too far.
Well, yeah. And these seem a little bit more balanced. The only one that seems broken
is the Ewok
one. The Ewok one seems broken.
Yeah.
But it's Territory Wars. This is kind of fun. I mean, this is like, you know, it's an event that'll happen twice, probably in the month of January. Mm-hmm. It's not a permanent broken effect. It shakes things up and also gives people a reward for having factions that are underused.
Yeah.
Three out of these four factions
are very underused.
Are very, very underused.
Fury of the Forest ability that they're going to get, apparently, with this data mine.
Yeah, this is crazy.
The cooldown of zero.
Crazy.
For all their abilities. So, I mean, the obvious ones are Wicked constantly using AoE ability, Elder constantly reviving. But the problem is Tebow.
100% turn meter.
100% turn meter loop over and over again.
Yeah.
Could be intended. Maybe they want you to use a character that can make sure you get rid of them right away. It
basically creates almost like two invincible teams.
Almost, yeah.
Yeah, you could have Tebow with, let's say, Wicket, and then the other five on defense, and Tebow and Wicket on offense. It's basically, and you know, but here's the good thing about this is, like, I know one of the biggest things that I had a problem with the C-3PO event is that I had to gear up characters that I may or may not use.
Yeah.
Like, and I actually, it's not like I was going to take them to 12, you know, but I'll take them to 10. And now this is like, oh, okay, they're useful.
Yeah, and plus Ewoks, they're going to be useful for Grand Arena, I think, since we need a big roster for Grand Arena.
And,
so.
Or if you didn't get C-3PO this time around, you know, next time you might, you know, you can start working on it anyway. So there's a second reason to actually get some benefit out of it.
Right. So I'm not going to talk too much about these because we both made videos about it. I'll leave a card in the top right-hand corner if you want to go check it out. But the only thing that really is kind of for us to kind of dig deeper into is this whole First Order bonus ability that we have here. What's it called? It's called Full-Blown Assault.
Right.
And you get all the bonuses. You're getting extra health and protection regeneration, which is kind of nice. It pairs with Crusader very well. But the target lock thing throws things off because target lock is a droid-specific mechanic.
Right.
IG-88, T3M4, Imperial Probe droid, and I'm probably missing one more off the top of my head. And it's like making us wonder, all right, it's a data mine. Maybe we're just going to be thrown off a little bit. It's not going to actually pan out.
They can do whatever they want.
Or it's indicating that maybe they're going to introduce a character from the First Order that can synergize with target lock. And, you know, we've been talking about that the developers have been teasing for a while. They're going to make droids meta. They're going to make them good. We're slowly getting there. C-3PO is not the complete picture for droids, I think. But BB-9E.
Right.
That could be it. First Order, droid, and talked about it before. Maybe you talked about it with me about having him just spam debuffs on the other team, and one of them is target lock.
Like an anti-illuminated destiny.
Anti-illuminated destiny, exactly. Right. So something to be excited about. I would greatly welcome BB-9E. I love droids. I have my droids very geared up. So seeing that paired up with First Order droid synergy, my goodness, that sounds like a lot of fun.
Yeah, that's what I thought when I read that. I was like, huh. BB-9E is the only way that makes any sense. You know, First Order droid.
I mean,
has to be BB-9E.
Yeah, it makes no sense they would put that in there and expect you to do IG-88, maybe, I guess.
It's too random to add.
It's very random.
Unless they had Hux, but it's been a droid mechanic.
It's always been a droid. And a target like the zero without the droids with that synergy with it. So, interesting. We just thought we'd point it out because it's something we're kind of digging deeper and kind of predicting what 2019 is going to introduce. Mm-hmm. You were talking about the other video. You think Darth Revan or Darth Malik's coming. I'm hoping Grievous, kind of like how the Millennium Falcon might be getting kicked over the next quarter. Mm-hmm. I'm hoping he's coming next quarter.
Yeah.
But the channel will be long gone by then.
Yeah, you get deleted. Ten more days.
Oh, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead, leave us a like, comment down below on all your thoughts, and be sure to subscribe to both of our channels. And until the next video.